It's in my mind, it's in my mind after all. Nothing but time, nothing but time is my fault. I'm floating between the white and black. Yeah, this with
put Oh yeah. You know what time it is. And here we go. Good evening, and welcome to a playoff edition of The Big Show. I'm your host, Big Chungus, and I'm coming to you live from the IGL mothership, and we've got a great one for you tonight, folks. It is 11:39 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time on September 4th, 2020, and today's a Friday, which means it's a great day for some KQB action. It is the semifinals of the IGL Summer Circuit, and for tonight's matchup, we are featuring Tier 1 West teams. Coming out of the blue corner at 5-3, we have the number 5 seeded Snail in the Coffin. And in the gold corner at 7-0, we have the undefeated number 1 seeded Soak Squad. To help me sort this all out, joining me to my right in studio on the ones and twos is my producer, Mr. Meeseeks. I also have a very special guest with me here tonight. You know her as a boss drone for her West Coast team, as well as a fantastic caster. Ladies and gentlemen, she puts the E in Terror Bears. Please welcome to the show, EG Free. Elise, welcome aboard.
Oh, thank you for having me, Chungus.
Absolutely. Glad to have you here. How you doing tonight?
I'm good. Excited to see the semifinals action on the West Tier 1. How are you
Absolutely.
doing?
Not bad, can't complain. This is a late one here, but I'm feeling fired up. I'm feeling good. So I think we're in for a fun one. It's a late night show and it is best of seven, so hope people got a little caffeine in their systems and they're awake because this should be a fun one.
Yeah, definitely. So excited to see this matchup between this undefeated Soak team, looking to take home, I believe, their first gold on the West Circuit against Snail in the Coffin, who's been a little bit of an underdog, kind of as a work their way up the bracket.
Yeah, they have. These guys are looking real strong. Last week they played the number 4 seeded Oops All Berries and they swept them 3-0. So they're coming in. They're probably feeling pretty good about themselves. Soak Squad, they had been undefeated not just in matches all season long, but also in sets. Last week, however, they went up against the number 8 seeded Golf Buddies and they got taken to the limit. They squeaked by with a 3-2 thrilling victory there. So that was a fun one. So both these teams coming in playing well. Soak Squad was looking maybe a little vulnerable there, and Snail in the Coffin coming in looking pretty hot.
Yeah, so I think we'll definitely see some good games here. I know Snail in the Coffin has been working pretty hard to try to figure out how do you crack this Soak stack,
Yep.
as also tried to figure out. So let's see if they are able to come up with a game plan to maybe take Soak down. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. Soak Squad again, they hadn't lost any sets all season long before getting touched up a little bit by Golf Buddies. So Snail in the Coffin, they got a chance here to do something not a lot of teams have been able to do this season. That is take some sets here off the Soak Squad and possibly come away with a victory. Let's get to it and let's take a look at some of these rosters here tonight. Starting of course with the Queens and the team's overall stats, you'll see Snail in the Coffin, a pretty strong military team. Their KDR is just over one, and look at that. Check out those snail numbers there. They're riding that snail pretty hard.
Yeah, they definitely are. And moving on to these queen stats, I'm really surprised to see some of these big numbers from both of these queens. I mean, you have Tree Bones, who is 33-8, Lunchmeat 27-5. I think most people in KQB would probably agree that Lunchmeat is one of the top queens, has consistently been one of the toughest queens to be, very consistent, really, really good at punishing drones and maces. But Tree Bones has been really impressing me in these past few matches. I don't know how many games of Snail in the Coffin you've had a chance to watch, Chungus, but he just has been getting better and better.
Yeah, he's coming on. His numbers are looking pretty good. He's a little over 4-1 KDR, and Lunchmeat kind of doing what he does. He's over 5-1. Soak Squad, of course, overall as a team, they're sporting a really strong KDR. Their berry numbers and snail numbers are down a little bit since the Beetlejuice patch. They have been going much more military, but still, you see there they've got some pretty strong objective presence as well. But both these teams, it seems like they're both very much in their element when they're able to mill up and just go toe to toe and do what they do best, and
Yeah.
that is their military games.
Yeah, definitely. I would definitely agree with that. I think the thing about Soak is that even though these numbers don't necessarily reflect big objective games, they are a team that can do anything. They can go full mill and pressure the enemy queen. They can go snail and they can get a win con that way. They also have some of the strongest berry runners on the West Circuit. I mean, I think Goose is one of the strongest flex players that I know personally, and he can get the kills, he can get the berries. Gnar too. We saw Danny against Golf Buddies getting those throws as well. So really strong flex team from this Soak squad.
Yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at those worker stats. Starting over with the side of Snail in the Coffin on the left there. They're gonna be in blue tonight. They've got Lightsaber Jeff. He's come on. He's also had an incredibly strong season. I know a couple days ago I said KG probably has my vote for most improved player this season, but I think Jeff, you can make a candidate. A strong argument for him being candidate as well. Here in the West, he's got 1-1 KDR, not easy to pull off as a worker. You see Hattrick and Earth Bowser there, also primarily doing work in the objective game. Earth Bowser, nice 7 berries per game and 700 snail yards. That's pretty nice. HDD doing what he does on the gold side for Soak, nearly 2-1 KDR. You mentioned Goose and everything he brings to the table, and Gnar, of course, a very strong objective worker as well.
Yeah, definitely. So you can see on these two teams that they both have a first mill that is pretty strong, and both Jeff, Lightsaber Metrics, and Danny, both of them are getting up. They're staying up most of their games. They're getting a lot of kills in return for their team. But we've got some really good flex stats from Hattrick and Earth Bowser on Snail in the Coffin side, and then Goose and Gnar over on Soak side. So I think we might have a looks like we might have a pretty even match between these teams with their roles tonight.
Yeah, so I think Snail in the Coffin, looking at their overall stats, it did seem like primarily they are a military snail team. Unfortunately for them, I would think that that maybe plays into Soak's hands. Soak is more comfortable when they are going toe to toe against military based teams. I don't know if you got to watch the other match I covered earlier this week, with KG's squad going up against Dark. For a while there, I thought part of the reason why my whole stack was in trouble was because they were trying to play Dark's game. They were trying to just square up, fight them, warrior v warrior, and that wasn't working out for them. And I mentioned, I think they had to stick with their game plan. They had to switch over, work the objective game, and that ended up working out well for them. I think similarly here with Snail in the Coffin, I'm a bit concerned that if they are trying to play a mainly military-based strategy, I think they're gonna run into some real problems. I think teams that have tried that against Soak typically have not fared well.
Yeah, it's definitely hard to run a full mill team against Soak, especially this Snail in the Coffin team has a little bit of a server disadvantage. I believe all three of these workers prefer the East Coast server versus a really strong West Coast stack over on this Soak side. So we'll see if Earth Bowser is going to come out hot with those berry throws, or if they're gonna try to switch up their game plan and tailor it like they did for Oops All Berries.
Yeah, so Earth Bowser and Hattrick Swayze there. I mean, really all of them. Jeff too. He's averaging 4 berries per game. I mean, these are very capable objective runners. I think for them to have a decent shot here, they're going to have to mix it up. I think you're going to have to give Soak some different looks. I think certainly there may be times when you can just line them up and go military or try and push snail. But I think at times you're going to have to try and show Soak some different things and try and run some berries. Throw them off a little
Yeah.
bit. You can't just do what they're going to expect you to do. Otherwise, I think you're kind of asking for a fair bit of trouble here.
Yeah, it's true. I will say though, one thing with being a berry team is knowing that you have a queen who can be a little bit slippery and stay alive, because it's a lot of pressure when you've got that full soak mill stack just coming at you hard, and you're sacrificing two of your workers to be thrown in the berries. So, but I'm sure that Tree Bones has probably been practicing a lot of that right now.
Yeah, so the formula that seemed to work very well last week for Golf Buddies was a couple things. One, it seemed to me like Rob, he was just playing really well. Rob really held his own. He gave those Soak workers some trouble. He held his own against Lunch Meat, which was no easy thing to do. So having your queen just not getting wiped quick and hanging in there and playing tough is really key against these guys. And then I think secondly, your workers have to come to the table, and again, they've got to be able to apply some pressure With their Barry game. And there is the aforementioned KG. I was just talking about that match. Thanks so much, KG, for bringing over your squad. Welcome aboard, guys. This is the pregame show of the big show. We're talking some strats here and previewing this matchup. It should be a fun one, and I'm so glad to have everyone aboard. Thanks for coming by. Yeah, so as I was saying, you know, I think Snail in the Coffin, they're going to have their work cut out for them, but they're going to have to mix it up, and Tree Bones is definitely going to have to hold his own here.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's going to be a little bit of an uphill battle for the Snail in the Coffin team, but they definitely have, I think, proved that they are here to hang in Tier 1, and they deserve this spot, and they definitely have a good amount of confidence going into this, and they could pull out a big upset.
Yeah, so for Snail in the Coffin, this is the farthest they've ever come in IGL before. These guys are in the semifinals. This is the farthest, I think, really any of these players, to my knowledge, has made it before. So I'm curious to see how experience plays out here. Soak Squad, they've had a handful of deep runs the playoffs last year. They made it to the finals at the end of their dominant regular season run. So I know that these guys are probably going to be playing loose. They've been playing together for a long time now. They joke around. They have a good time. I'm curious to see how Snail in the Coffin handles that aspect of things. All these players, interestingly, have been around the league for quite some time. I mean, Tree Bones has been around for a while. He's name changed. I think he's on his third name now. So he's certainly no stranger to the KQB community. All these players have been around for quite some time. I don't know how long they've been playing together. And again, this is the farthest they've ever come before. So I will be interested to see how they handle the playoff pressure. Because as you know firsthand, playoffs are a whole different animal.
Yeah, it's true. It's very true. I mean, Terror Bears went up against Soak last year in West, and I believe that was a 3-0 outcome, so I definitely get it. I definitely understand. I think one thing that you pointed out that is really important is just how long this Soak squad has been together. They've played in all three seasons that we've had so far as a team with pretty much the same lineup, a little bit different. First season you played over Gnar. And so I think that that's one thing that they really have going in their favor is they are just so coordinated on every single map that they do, and they know exactly how each of their teammates is going to play, and it really shows. You can see the cohesion on almost every single time that you play them. And so that's something that Tree Bones and the rest of this stack is going to have to try to figure out how to combat because they don't have as much experience playing together.
Yeah, certainly. I am curious to see how the experience shakes up for both teams. You did mention last season's Terror Bears, and you are on Terror Bears, and you guys are very much alive and well, both on the East and West, the only remaining team to be present on both sides of things. So the winner of this match will go up against the winner of your matchup that you've got this week. It's you guys against, remind me, who are you playing on the West here? Dave's Killer Queen.
We play Dave's Killer Queen tomorrow. Really excited for that match. So that is a lot of arcade buddies of both Oboe and I. Oboe knows Walshy very well. They played arcade together in the same city for many, many months. So they are definitely familiar with each other's play styles. I'm super excited to play against two of my good girlfriends in MK Steel and Jelloey. So really pumped about that. We think it might be the most females present in a semifinal ever. So we're really stoked on that.
Oh, that's pretty
excited
cool
to get some more femmes playing competitively.
Nice.
So it'll be a good game. Both of our teams have very similar play styles. So I'm really excited to see us kind of juke it out.
Very cool. So yeah, that is the 2-3 matchup there. So winner of both these games will play each other, and the losers will go down into the bronze medal match. So yeah, so if you guys go ahead and check out B's Almanac, which she's put so much work into. She's done a lot for this community, the Almanac being one of those things. Do check out that TV guide. We've still got a few more matches left this week. Tomorrow is the aforementioned Terror Bears versus Killer Queen match that it will be brought to you by Jeff on his Twitch channel. Sunday will be Smooth Sailing over against Tier 2. That is a Tier 2 matchup East, and KG will be hosting that, our very own KG here in the house. And then Monday, we've got two matches on the docket. Big one, once again, Terror Bears, their East Coast version, going up against Yeet House. Penguin will be casting that one. And then, of course, the Tier 3 matchup of Corn Queen at Temp. So lots of matches still going on, lots of KQB action to be had this week. And then we've got the final medal round next week. So a lot going on.
Yeah, really excited to see what teams end up shaking out for all of these tiers. It's been
Yeah.
some good games.
Yeah, this has been a really fun season. I think one of the more unpredictable seasons so far. We've had some upsets happen here in the playoffs, and that doesn't happen a heck of a lot typically in KQBIGL history. The past
Yeah.
couple seasons, it's been pretty cookie cutter in terms of the higher seeding teams winning their matchups. But this season, we've had quite a few upsets, so it's been really fun to watch.
Yeah, we have. I mean, even just looking at this Tier 1 East bracket, we have a lot of teams that were seeded kind of differently, did not make it in the bracket as we thought that they would. So it's been interesting to see kind of these new teams come together and really be able to keep up with some of the top tier players who have been playing the game for a few seasons. So that's a really a good sign in our community. I think that we're growing and we're developing.
Absolutely, I agree. Keep my eye on the big chat here. I do see Bees giving a shout out for the Puppy Bowl next week. That happened last season too, and I know that that was a really big success. People had a lot of fun with that one, and so that will be back once again. So do keep an eye out for that. And if you got kids, hit up Bees and the other organizers and try and get them on in.
Yeah, love to see some choo-choo woo-woo. Round two.
That's right. Yeah, that was a fun one last year, so I'm glad that they're bringing that back. As Daddy mentioned also a couple nights ago when she was here on the show, there is going to be the BYO tea happening. So bring your own team tournament. That will be happening October 10th and 11th, I believe she said. I believe I have those dates correct. So be sure to sign up for that as well. So a lot still going on here, a lot of games left to be had this season. And do go ahead if you haven't already, start to register your teams. I know it sounds early, but go ahead and register your teams for the upcoming winter circuit too.
Yeah. All right. And it looks like we might be starting to get these teams into a custom match, so it might be showtime.
It might be. We're getting there. Big show running on time here tonight. Just a few minutes to midnight. So EG, I gotta put you on the spot here. What are you thinking? How's this gonna pan out tonight?
I'll be honest, I might get in trouble for saying this later, but I think this Soak team is just looking so coordinated. They're definitely the favorite to win Tier 1 West. There's a reason why they had not dropped any sets until they played Golf Buddies last week. So I think it's gonna be tough for Sail in the Coffin, but this team is really gelling well together. They're putting in a lot of hard work, and I think we're seeing it pay off. And I'll be honest, this is the best I've ever seen Treebones play. Treebones has really come onto the scene this season and has shown that he is a true Tier 1 queen who can hang with the best of them. So I wouldn't be surprised if there's an upset, but I think it's gonna be really hard for the Sail in the Coffin team to get there.
Yeah, Treebones has been having himself a really great season. As you mentioned before, all these guys, no strangers. They've all been around for a long time. Treebones, Y, he's been around for a while now. And he's, I believe, always been in Tier 1. I was gonna say maybe high end tier 2, but I'm pretty sure he's always been a tier 1 competitor. But it does feel like this season he definitely took a bit of a leap, and his team has been looking pretty strong. They ended the regular season at 3-3, but they have managed to get a couple wins under their belt here and moved on up to 5-3, so they're looking pretty strong.
Yeah, they are. And I mean, this Snail in the Coffin team was formerly known as Snailer Moon last season on West, and I believe they ended the season winless. And so to go from winless to the semifinals in one season with only one roster change is a huge deal, I think. And I think that's a commitment to how hard everybody on this team has been working, especially Treebones. I've just been so impressed with him.
Yeah, you mentioned only one roster change, but that one roster spot was a big one.
It is.
Jeff has been doing a lot of work for them. He's again been playing really awesome this season, as has Treebones. So those two guys have really stepped up their game, and this whole team has benefited greatly because of it.
Yeah, they definitely have. I mean, we all know what a great player Jeff is. We've seen him play on Tear Bears on the East and then the Snail in the Coffin team, and he's been absolutely crushing it this season. So definitely don't need to go into that any further. I think most people would probably are aware of that.
I believe so. I think people have seen him and seen all the hard work he's put in, and probably seen a couple of his highlights as well. So Certainly, he's been doing a phenomenal job here. It looks like these guys are about ready to get started. Elise, I gotta ask, how are you guys feeling about your upcoming matchups here? You guys still have two this weekend.
Yeah, so we're feeling pretty good. We're really excited to play Dave's Killer Queen on West tomorrow night, and then we will play Yeet House on Monday. Yeah, we're super excited. I mean, we've just been playing a little bit here and there, doing a little bit of a VOD review, figuring out what type of strats we want to run. So we're definitely excited, but our team has always been really focused on kind of two things. The first and the most important is have fun. And luckily we have a great group of people, so we always are having fun for the most part. And then the second is we have a kind of like a laid back, try hard attitude. So as long as we're doing those two things, we know we're on the right path and kind of how it's going right now. So,
nice.
So far so good.
Yeah, you guys have a real tough one in that Yeet House matchup. Again, that team is essentially the East Coast version of Golf Buddies without Yeesh, I believe. But it is that Golf Buddies team that took Soak here to the brink. They took two sets off them. And those guys have been looking really well coordinated. They are a KQA group. They've been around, known each other for a long time. And, man, yeah, those guys are really gelling. Rob's playing phenomenal at the queen position. Saw some really great warrior work at AG, and that team is just clicking.
Yeah, they are. They definitely are. And so that team has pretty much been around since season one in some way, shape, or form. I mean, that core group of Rob, AG, and Nubs has really played a lot together since probably the beta, I would say, almost. I think Rob is maybe one of the oldest queens from the start. And so they've been grooving, and they have been looking really good. I think they have their strats worked out really well. Eduardo's mace is very scary, to say the least. So that's definitely something we're going to be looking out for. But we're excited to play them. They're going to be good games. They did beat us in regular season, so we're looking for a little bit of a vengeance on that.
Yeah, that's going to be a good one. There's still a lot of good games left this weekend, and I'm definitely curious to see how you guys do there. Again, you guys are the last team alive in both conferences. You were able to take home third place last season, so you guys got a chance to break on through to your first finals as well.
Yep, definitely. We're gunning for it. Look to see us in both of those finals. We're definitely trying.
Absolutely. And here, again, this would be Snail in the Coffin's first finals appearance. If they can get a win tonight, as it is, this is already their first semifinals appearance. Soak Squad, of course, trying to get back to the finals like they were able to last year and take home their first gold. They've had some deep playoff runs. They've made it to the finals. They've made it to the semifinals the season before. Yet to take home the gold, but they're trying to get there, and to do so, they're going to have to plow on through Snail in the Coffin, and it looks like these guys are just about ready to get started.
Yeah, really excited to see these teams play out. I think it'll be really interesting to see the map rotation as well, too. I think that there's definitely some maps that are going to favor both teams a little bit more than the others.
Yep, absolutely, I agree. Looks like they are ready to start. We hear them saying good luck. I am curious to see the map loadout here. Again, I think Snail in the Coffin, they're going to want to try and work their objective game a little bit if they can. I know Soak, they're certainly comfortable doing whatever the case may be, whether it's objective or military. But typically when teams square up against them full-on mill, it does not work out well. So let's see what Snails are able to pull off here. And we're starting off with the new map in the flats.
Yeah, I'll be honest, this map lineup looking pretty good for Soak. I'd be a little nervous if I was a Snail in the Coffin.
Well, let's see how Snail starts things off here. Curious to see what their open is like, if they're going to try and go Snail. Yup, and Earthbrowser and Gnar jockeying for that Snail position. We see those two guys dancing down below. The other two Soak guys getting up mill. And, big clears down below. Pretty much everyone going down except for Hattrick, and it looks like Goose are still alive.
Yeah, so we have Hattrick is still hanging out in that snail tunnel, but just like that, we have Snail in the Coffin is wiped.
Yep, slight snail advantage for blue side. That snail approaching the grass there. Neither team really going heavy on the berries, but Goose drawing first blood, getting that kill on Tree Bones.
Yeah, Goose is so good at hanging out in that wrap between those two gates, and he will just camp those side gates as the queen is trying to tag him. He's so good at doing that.
And he almost had another one there on Tree Bones, and yes, he is. He loves hanging down that wrap and catching unsuspecting queens off guard as he's doing now, and there it is, like clockwork. He was hanging out in the wrap, caught Tree Bones diving down. He's working on his Hattie.
Yeah, and so we have Nars maybe looking to get up Super Soldier here.
Yep, Lunch's I think so.
Doing a great job of holding those columns to get Nar up.
All right, here we go. Nar is styling now. He's got the Super Soldier. Goose is up, hanging out in those wraps. Danny's up. They're going to go full Snail, full Warrior, rather, while Blue does push Snail a little bit. So we are in the grass.
Ooh, big kill from Hattrick
there
on.
There it is. Yep.
Oh, so scary.
Somehow Tree Bones gets out of that. He was hovering right next to Danny there. Goose wants it.
Yeah, you can tell Tree Bones is a little scared of Goose in that wrap. He is definitely staying far away from those side gates right now, opting to only build on this middle gate.
Yeah, it looks like Blue's inching along that Snail. They're almost out of the grass patch there. Oh, Goose had him. Tree Bones manages to get out as the Snail is just about on its way out. And there it is. Lunchmeat finishes off the kill, giving Gold Side their first win.
Great job from Soak there with that military pressure. They definitely, I think Goose was the MVP of that map. I mean, those two first kills on Tree Bones. Tree Bones didn't go down and tag those side gates for the rest of the map because he knew he couldn't go down there on last. So that really cut off Tree Bones' area to only that center space, which really good positioning for Lunch to take advantage of.
Yep. Absolutely. And here we go, heading on over to Tally. This is my favorite map, and this is a map Soak Squad has a couple different opens. Here we see them getting HDD up real quick for his Legend. He gets a nice mace clear there. Neither team really not able to do a heck of a lot in the Barry game. Gold Side a little slow start. See them missing a throw there, but it looks like they are trying to push their berries while Blue's content to ride that Snail once again.
Yeah, so Danny's doing a great job on this Blue ledge right now, just making sure that they're not able to get anything in. And I don't think we've seen very little mill for this Snail in the Coffin team, but the Snail is almost it's getting a little scary.
Yeah, they're pushing objectives real hard. They're running a split objective approach, it looks like. Ooh, we see Goose, nice berry work there, getting in a couple. Gold just needs four as Tree Bones goes down. But yeah, they're running a split objective strat. Very interesting. No mill, as you mentioned. They had two berry runners and one Snail runner. But eventually, Gold Side able to counter that, take down Tree Bones, and now Gnar is going to run that Snail back to at least the neutral position.
Mm-hmm. I mean, berries are not that far behind on Snail in the Coffin, but
no,
they
not.
Only just got a ledge up in Jeff, so we'll see how this is going to go.
Okay, so Earth Browser able to sneak one in, Goose sneaks one in, so it's 5-2 left, and Lunchmeat goes down. Nice kill.
Yeah, but Danny with the throw, you know Danny's not dunking it.
You know, the man doesn't put in the live berries, but he does like to get in that last one sometimes, and it is.
I was impressed in the Golf Buddies match. He definitely, there were throws that he was hitting left and right.
Oh, he knows them.
Yeah, as a first mill who rarely goes down, Danny really doesn't have to run berries that often. So
no, he
can very easily not learn the throws, but he's showing he's a team player. He's flexing.
He knows the throws, and he even knows some berry shots from the warrior position. He knows how to chip in a couple. He's practiced some shots with his mace. He's got a few shots lined up. He keeps that for special occasions.
Jeff just ran across the entire map beaming Danny in the face 3 or 4 times. That was really fun to watch.
All right, both teams here looking like they're going mill heavy. Only one berry in Hive. That's not going to do much. Snail hasn't really moved. So it looks like we're headed for a slugfest here.
Yeah, so Tree Bones is doing a pretty good job avoiding these gold warriors, but he is in a bad position right now.
Yeah, I've seen...
Just barely...
Ooh,
wow,
somehow Lunch goes down.
Yeah, I thought Lunch was going to have that kill for him for sure.
Yeah,
but
Tree Bones dancing with the devil there. I've seen him go down into the trap house a couple times. He's playing risky, but so far it seems to be paying off for him.
Yeah, Tree Bones just apparently doesn't need any warriors. He can play the game by himself.
I can do this all by myself. Blue, they are going to have to get up at some point. Gold doing a really good job locking out Blue. Hattrick finally gets up there, right side gate. Let's see if he can do something with his warrior, but Tree Bones does go down.
Yeah, and we do get our first warrior up for this blue side. We are gonna maybe get to see them go out full mill. We are gonna get the Earth Bowser sword. Love to see it.
Now, Gold has been quietly moving that snail along. I saw Goose riding that. It looks like Gnar may try and get there now with his shield. So that's snail in a very dangerous position for blue.
Yeah, and we are equal on queen lives, though, so it could be anybody's game at this point in time. I think it's going to come down to whose mill can stay up a little bit longer. And so far, that's been favoring Soak.
It has. And Goose there almost had a nice kill. Oh, another one. Wow. There's lots of really great. And there's the kill. Gnar swooping in with the mace. Wow, some really nice military play on all sides happening down the right side. But eventually, Soak comes out on top. Blue is wiped. Gold, however, doesn't have any runners who can hop on that snail. But maybe they don't need it. They do have Tree Bones on last life.
Yeah, so this is a hard situation because Tree Bones doesn't want to pick off one of these gold warriors, but he really needs to get rid of this pressure.
And there it is, the pinch from the Soak brothers. Goose and Danny had him, nowhere to go for Tree Bones, and Soak Squad's going to take that first set.
Yeah, really great job from Goose and Danny there with that pinch, and strong numbers from this Soak Squad. I mean, you got Danny's 23-7. Looking really good. Goose also has a positive KD. Gnar's got some big snail for his team pushing that objective. And they've definitely limited the berries from the snail and the coffin team.
Yeah, they were really able to contain that. We saw on Tally, Danny got up right off the bat, was able to lock down that hive and did a really good job there. So yeah, Blue wasn't able to really get too much traction going in the objective game and find themselves down 1-0.
Yeah, what do you think this snail in the coffin team needs to adjust right now, Chungus, to be a little bit more competitive in some of these maps?
I feel like the warriors played pretty well. They hung tough in there. They weren't going down all that easily to Soak's workers. I feel like Tree Bones played pretty well too. He was taking some risks, but he wasn't dying all that easily either. So I think they're gonna have to keep up their military play and maybe try and get just a little bit more out of their objective game.
Yeah.
And this map is a great opportunity for them to do so.
Yeah, both of these maps, Helix and Split Juniper, might be a little bit better for this strong berry team and Snail in the Coffin. But
yeah.
You can't sleep on Soak's Helix either. It's
now,
very strong.
I'm curious to see what Snail in the Coffin does here. I know that they have been opting for some double military loadouts at the start. But okay, no, looks like they're going to open up with two berry runners. So their berry game looking good. Soak, though, also countering, making all their throws as well. And Treebos is down one life.
Yeah, and big punish right there from Lunch onto the Snail in the Coffin mace, and so that they are wiped. And you have Danny's in this ledge for Soak. It's going to be really hard for the Snail in the Coffin team to get past him. I think he's one of the best sword ledges in the game.
Yeah, Tree Bones is going to have to try and get in there and clear him out, but he can't really leave the gold hive. And down he goes. He's on last life. We do see Earth Browser has gotten up, but he gets clear too. And that's probably going to be game here, unless Tree Bones can come up with some legendary here. He does get a kill on Lunchmeat, though.
Yeah, and great steal from Jeff and Lightsaber Metrics to get that berry out of the hive. But before that, Goose had a really nice throw.
Oh, Danny almost knocked in the berry with his sword. That berry just missed. That would have been a pretty epic ending. But it looks like Goose had an open layup there. But Gnar ends the drama with the kill.
So right before that, Gnar took out both of the blue ledges with his mace and then swooped on over with great positioning to not only protect Goose with that berry, but also got that kill on Tree Bones. So great play there from Gnar.
Yeah, blue had a good open. They were looking sharp. They went with a 2 eco strat and they were making all their throws. Things were pretty even to start, but then Soak just pulled out ahead once they were able to take down that blue military. And down goes Lunchmeat.
Yeah, and look at this drone ledge from Hattrick. We're just getting our first berry in for this Soak Squad. Well, you know I love a drone ledge.
Yeah, both teams off to a kind of a slow start here on Split, content to get up some warriors. And yes, we do see we had the drone ledge going for a while. Neither team pushing snail much. I thought Blue may, they might try to shake things up and work that snail, but no, they're going for more traditional eco approach. Each queen down one life.
Yeah, so we do have, we're gonna get one up in lightsaber metrics right now. Goose is putting in work with this mace, though. He's giving Tree Bones a hell of a time, and he did just take out lightsaber metrics.
Nice clear.
This Goose mace is looking amazing right now.
Tree Bones getting his second kill of the map on Lunch Meat. He's playing well.
Yeah, and so Lunch Meat is now on last, but he does have Hot Dick Danny up ledging right now, so.
And Blue's ahead on berries.
Soak Squad.
Blue's ahead, Goose just waterfalls and buries down there though, and he can get him in quick. He knows all those throws. So the tide could turn, but there it is. Tree Bones getting all three kills. And I see Lord Fish is calling for it in chat. He wanted to see the Tree Bones aggression. He got the Tree Bones aggression.
Yeah. And a little shout out to Retro in the chat as well. Three phones, because Tree Bones has got your number. He did have a number on that map.
Yeah, Tree Bones played well. Very nice. It takes a lot of guts going toe-to-toe with Lunch Meat like that, and that map there, it paid off.
Yeah, so I'm interested
in Nard's once playoff. Again!
Yeah, Tree Bones, he's ready to play. He's here, and we're only going to be able to get Goose up on this Soak side while we're getting a Jeth, Hattrick, and Earth Bowser up full mill for Snail in the Coffin.
Lobster Buster calling for Skew That Meat. We have seen four straight kills by Tree Bones against Lunch Meat. Let's see if Blue can continue some of this momentum. They've got the full mill out.
Yeah, and so we've got Jeff is hanging out in this wrap right now looking for that kill on Lunch, but he is taken down from Goose. But Tree Bones is just killing these Soak Warriors left and right. Another one on Gnar.
Yeah, he's feeling himself right now. He's doing a phenomenal job, and that's exactly the kind of performance they're going to need out of him for his team to be able to hang tight here tonight.
Yeah, but we are seeing the typical Soak speed warrior coming back up. So we do have Gnar with a speed sword. He is known as one of the queen killers.
Ooh.
But Tree Bones!
He is. Yeah, last match. Okay, there we go. Lunch Meat getting some revenge. Gnar was absolutely on fire against Golf Buddies. He was getting lots and lots of queen kills. And we did see Lunch Meat here starting to come alive. Oh, but Hattrick with a nice turn.
Yeah.
Getting the kill, finishing things off. Yeah, Snail.
Snail in the Coffin is at their first lead so far in the semifinals. So.
Yep. They are up 2-1. One more map here will even things up at one set apiece. We are going to Spire, another military heavy map. Soak Squad here are going to have to win out these last two maps to not give ground.
Yeah, Soak was looking really strong on this Spire map last time. Tree Bones was playing out of his mind amazing, but it was really hard for Snail in the Coffin to just get Warriors up.
Okay, so we're going to see once again another Tree Bones kill against Lunch Meat. So he's down one life. We do have Danny is up for Gold Side. Blue, they've got two military up. Now Gnar is up as well. So two Warriors apiece. Let's see what happens.
Tree Bones.
This man is on fire right now. Soak has no answer for him. Somebody stop that crazy man.
Yeah, Tree Bones is definitely, he's vicious. You got your wish. Tree Bones is bringing out the aggression, and he's bringing it hard on Lunch Meat.
Wow, I'm stunned right now. Don't know what to say. The hat trick.
Honestly, Chungus, I'm not. Tree Bones has been looking good. We've been facing Tree Bones in ranked. I've been hearing from his team about how he's been playing. I've been seeing it firsthand. Tree Bones is here. He's definitely ready to compete.
Man, not many queens will get a hat trick against the great Lunch Meat. I saw Tree Bones do it right there. He had, I believe, two queen kills the map before. A nice 26-5 KDR. Man, that set was all Tree Bones. What can you say?
Yeah, so I think this is a little bit of that momentum that Snail in the Coffin needs right now to compete with Soak. And so I guess when I asked you earlier, what do they need to do? They just need to unleash Tree Bones.
They do. They need to go all in on Tree Bones. Yeah, that's exactly it. I mean, really, that's what we saw from Golf Buddies last week. That's how they're able to hang tough with Soak. They got phenomenal queen play out of Rob. And that's really what it takes when you're at this point in the playoffs. You've got to have really top-tier queen play. Otherwise, it's really, really hard to pick up maps. But certainly, they're getting that here tonight.
Yeah. I mean, I know even at the end of last season, Treebones was debating if he was going to keep queening or not. I know we had a conversation about whether he wasn't sure if he was going to be able to compete at this tier one level, and now he's getting hat tricks on lunch. Let's go, Treebones.
Let's go, Treebones. All right. Back to Tally. Last time we saw Soak win this map, and here we go, lunch meat. You know, he's fired up. He doesn't like to see what's been going on as of late. So he's getting a little revenge kill. Gold putting in their berries, although they are missing a couple shots there. But they're way ahead on berries. So let's see if Soak Squad's going to get back on track here.
Yeah, just like that, Tree Bones is able to scrap it out with Lunch on that right gate, trying to get up lightsaber metrics and takes down Lunch, so they're even on queen lives, but
Oh.
two berries left for the Soak team.
Yeah, so two berries left. Lunch does go down again. He's just got to stay alive now. We see Danny trying to work the berry game. Ooh, nice toss by Goose in traffic. Just one more to go. Danny's picking up the berry. Can he get it once again? Oh, he misses the throw, though.
Yeah,
Oh, he
Goose has
had
been
it
really
lined up.
consistent with these
Oh,
Goose, as soon as
another
I say
missed
that,
throw.
caster's curse, but he's been really, really consistent with these throws.
So both Silk Bros missing a toss there so close. Each one had it lined up. Oh, Gnar coming in, finishing the job where his two teammates could not. But Silk Squad does find a way to get the win, having a bit of
Yeah.
replay difficulties there. But yeah, man, Gnar swooping on in, finishing it off.
Yeah, great job with Gnar to have kind of that map vision to realize that Goose and Danny were coming from the right side of the map and he needed to come in from the left.
Yep. So Soak Squad dodged a bullet there. Lunch Meat was on his last life. That would have been a massive momentum swing for Snail in the Coffin, but
Three
they don't
bones.
need it because they get the kill anyways here to start off, and Treebones winning the open once again.
Yeah, man, it is just the Tree Bones show right now. I'll tell you, we're gonna get up a Speed Sword Earth Bowser. I am so excited to see what Earth Bowser does with this Speed Sword.
Yeah, blue is full mill right now. Soak gonna have up two warriors of their own though, but they are down one queen life, and they are chasing Lunch Meat hard.
Man, this is I would say if you took away the names right now, I would think this blue team was actually Soak and Gold was Snail in the Coffin.
Yeah, they are swarming right now. Those guys are looking very aggressive.
Earth
They do
Bowser.
have cold side wiped, and they're just all over the place.
Wow.
They've got a full lockout going right now, so all gates are in their control. They've got three military, one of them is speed, and
Oh,
there it
that
is.
pinch,
Pays
that
off.
beautiful pinch. Beautiful pinch, I believe, between lightsaber metrics and Hatrix Swayze, and lunch is on last.
Yep, lunch on last. Gold has nobody up. Wow, really nice play there. Okay, Lunch Meat does go down. He had a nice play, ducking on in there, getting the gate. But man, Earth Browser doing work.
I'm so impressed with the Snail in the Coffin team right now. I mean, I know we talked a little bit in the pregame show about playing their own game, but it looks like right now they're playing the full mill Soak game and
They
they're
are.
pulling it off. I'm impressed.
Yeah, interestingly enough, they've been having very good success on the military maps, and it's been Soak Squad who's been making hay on the objective maps.
Yeah,
Man,
but Tree
Lunch Meat
Bones is
goes
on
down again.
fire right
He is.
now.
Soak Squad has been getting their wins on maps here, like Helix, like Tally. So it's been Soak Squad really who's been making hay with the berries, and
Yeah,
Blue has been more content to push military.
I will say though, this blue team only has a single berry in right now. If I were them, I would probably almost switch to a full mill. I mean, they can
Yeah.
get caught up pretty quickly, but it's gonna be pretty hard, I
Yeah,
think.
since Beetlejuice, especially now with famines being a very much realistic threat, it's gonna be really hard to make up the necessary ground. But man, we do see Lunch on last life. So I
Yeah.
think Blue, they're chipping away here. They only do need five, but I think it might be too little too late. There's that berry, full berry patch in the top right up there, but I think that's gonna be hard for Blue to get to. Oh,
Tree
Tree Bones,
Bones.
what is going on?
Another hat trick.
Are you kidding me?
I'm blown away right now, Tree Bones. This is absolutely incredible. I'm very proud of Tree Bones right
Wow.
now.
So, Snail in the Coffin going up 2 games to 1. They got a chance to take a 2-set to 1 lead here if they can get another win on split, and they did win here last set.
Oh, and lunch though.
Okay, there we go.
The kill in the wrap and denying the form on the left gate.
Yep.
So
lunch stepping up.
Really good for Soak.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Nar didn't miss a throw, but Soak squad overall doing pretty well in their berries. Ooh, Danny with the glance and eventually does go down to tree bones. That would have been a nice kill there. So gold is up on berries, but blue not terribly far behind here. Still a lot of time.
Yeah. Interesting kill from Tree Bones on that left gate. I'm not sure if he tagged that drone coming out of the gate, but looked like there maybe should have been some iframes there. It looked a little off to me.
Big strong elbow bump to you, Icy Shark. Thanks so much for the follow. Okay, and here we go. Tree Bones continuing his trail of destruction, getting a kill. And oh, here we go. Nice counter by Lunchmeat. Thank you to, once again, another follower. Thanks so much. Having a hard time keeping up with all you guys. Thanks so much for the follows and tuning in here tonight. We do have Soak Squad versus Snail in the Coffin semi-final action. We are tied up at one set apiece here. But Snail in the Coffin in the lead in this set, 2-1.
Yeah, so we do have nobody up for the Snail in the Coffin team, and only one berry left for this gold team. Oh no, a missed throw, and Goose is going to capitalize on it.
Yep, so they're all done with tops.
Yeah, a little bit of a misplay from this Snail in the Coffin team, but great job from Goose to recognize that and to make sure that he went up there and got it in.
Yeah, Gnar is patrolling down low with that gun. Okay, he does go down. There's lots of berries down low, though. Goose can get these in real quick, so Blue's going to have some problems. I do have Jeff Legend down low. If there's one guy you want Legend on the blue side, Jeff is your man. But boy, there's a lot of berries down there. You know, Goose is... he's going to have a field day trying to get those in.
Yeah, and I mean, you have Danny ledging up on this top for Snail in the Coffin, so it's going to be hard. But Gnar, with this gun, is he going to be able to take out Jeff?
Yeah.
Oh, Jeff, ooh. Big punish on lunch right there.
That's huge.
He's able to sneak one.
Oh, HDD. Wow. Okay, risky play by HDD. Man, okay. That's a veteran. Nice move by HDD. He saw he had the time. He abandoned his ledge up top. He knew that lunch had just gone down and that Soak needed the help down low. So he took the risk. He left his hive and goes down and got a big, big clear on Jeff. And that opened things up for Soak to get those last couple berries in. So
yeah.
Very well played by HDD.
Yeah, so we are going to get our first game 5 of this series so far. Let's go. Shout out to Andre Actor. Sorry, all your dream is not alive, but we're always happy to have a game 5.
Okay, so game 5 here, where we started it all, in the Nesting Flats. We're going to see, looks like these guys on the Soak side are looking for those power-ups, while Blue, happy to ride the Vanilla Snail.
Yeah, you can see Jeff was trying to kind of take care of Goose in that wrap. Goose was able to take him down because that was such a hard time for Tree Bones on this last Beetlejuice.
Oh, there was some nice clash in there. Gnar did go down. We do have HDD up on speed. That's scary news if you are blue side, but both queens are still with full stock right now.
Yeah, love to see Lunchmeat going through the little slit into the hive. I think we need to figure out a name in the community for what we're going to call
what
that.
We're going to call that, yeah. Okay, all right, well, we see Lunchmeat there drawing first blood of this map, gang and kill on Tree Bones. Ooh, Danny just missed Tree Bones as well. So gold looks like they're coming alive now. They've got full mill, two of them are speed. Now, this is bad news for blue.
Oh, Tree Bones. Just barely
there
gets a bit Gnar, but Goose, I mean,
cleans
Goose
him up.
This wrap has been a total game changer for this Soak team.
Yeah.
I think there's no way Tree Bones is hanging out at those bottom gates. Look at him, his head is glued to the ceiling.
Yeah, on this map in particular, Goose has been a menace. Overall, Goose is having a very, very good match. I feel like his military play has been strong, and he's been leading the way for the Soak berries as well.
Yeah, they are going to have to answer this snail. Great pinch there from Gnar and Goose to take down the blue warrior.
Goose gets another kill down low.
Blue is wiped.
Yeah,
wiped blue. With Tree Bones on last life. This is looking a little scary.
Yeah, this is not good for them. We see that Earth Bowser's got the speed. He does go down, though. Not able to make too much progress on that snail. Blue's going to have to get some military up. And, okay, there it is.
Oh,
there's one
Jeff.
Kill.
Big kill from Jeff. Gnar goes down from Tree Bones. This is looking a little bit better okay. for Snail the Coffin.
Yep.
They have the snail.
All of a sudden, they've got the snail moving. So tides may be a turn in here. They've got two military up. They got Earth Bowser continuing to ride that snail. They're going to bait. Ooh, nice clears though by Danny. Swooping in.
Yeah.
Not falling for the bait, not getting killed. And now a gold's going to have an opportunity to pull that snail out of the danger zone and reclaim their strong position here.
Yeah, and Tree Bones has been doing such a good job running on this map, but Danny has just not let that snail make very little progress.
Yeah. Yeah, Danny's got that snail locked down. He's doing a great job of keeping himself alive and clearing off those workers.
Yeah.
Oh, and finally gets the kill on that blue soldier as well. Man, Danny, he brought his A game here tonight.
Uh-oh, Tree Bones is in a really bad spot
yeah,
right now. Great job. Is able to take down Danny. That's going to be a big game changer for Snail in the Coffin right now. Because they do not move that snail with him there.
Gold, they're going to have to move that snail back. Blue's slowly inching that along. Danny, his running snail is not his favorite thing in the world, but he's kind of got no choice here. He's going to have to hop on that and pull it out of the danger zone here.
Yeah. No, this snail is so close for Snail in the Coffin.
It is.
You almost want to see them just try to get a mace up and just try to hold that space a little bit. Goose is being so patient right now.
Earth Bowser was doing some really, really good work there. He eventually does go down. Oh, Jeff trying to hold his own. He clashes. But Silk eventually getting the better of Blue here. And Blue is wiped. They are going to have Jeff up top. But it's going to take a little bit of time. Oh, he does go down. And here we go. I think Danny's going to be content to, just get it in the grass. And now he's going to try and get up.
Yeah, Tree Bones is just, he's been running for so long. He's been doing such a good job rebuilding on that middle gate, staying away from the bottoms because Goose.
Oof.
But Lunch, great bait there from Lunch to try to pull Tree Bones into that hill and punishes instead.
That was a long map. Lunch Meat eventually got there, and that was a well-played game five, and neither team wanted to go down there. Man, check out Goose's numbers. 20 berries. That's real strong stuff there. I'd mentioned before, I think Goose, so far all around, having himself a phenomenal match here so far tonight.
Yeah, you love to see the double digits there. The 12 kills, 20 berries. Really good from Goose. Love to see that double-double.
Yep.
Big stats all around. I mean, Danny with the positive KD. We had big numbers from Jeff. Tree Bones playing out of his mind in those matches.
Yeah.
Really strong showing from both teams.
Yeah, that was a phenomenal set there. Near team one to drop that set five. And it looks like we're having maybe some connectivity issue here. Danny booted out. Wonder what's going on.
You don't like to see that.
No, that we don't like to see.
Not at all.
But so far, I gotta say, great match. The first set, Soak Squad came out swinging. They took it down pretty quick. I started to think, okay, maybe this is going to be Soak doing what they do. Maybe it's going to be a quick one here tonight. But since then, Snail in the Coffin has played super well. They came out one set two in really commanding fashion. And then set three was a real nail biter here.
Yeah, so looking pretty good for this Soak Squad right now, up 2-1. But I've been really impressed with Tree Bones' play and Snail in the Coffin overall. So it's been super entertaining games.
Yeah. Yeah, Tree Bones has been playing phenomenal. We've seen some really strong play from Jeff. Earth Bowser there was doing some work too with his warrior. So overall, blue side looking pretty impressive.
Yeah. Hearing from Andres in the chat, Danny too OP, so they had to kick him.
That makes sense. I think that's what's going on. We're missing one from Blue. Who is that we're missing here? Hattrick.
Probably Hattrick, yeah.
So either he's having connectivity issues, or perhaps Blue is looking to make a substitution.
Yeah. I would love to see a little Chuck Berry action. Hattrick has been playing amazing, but always love to see Chuck Berry. Maybe he's grabbing some hot pockets, like Penguin says.
That's always a possibility. You can't rule that out.
Yeah.
Now, so far, this has been a good match, though. These guys are not disappointing. There we go. Hattrick is back in action, so can only assume there were some connectivity problems here. Not too much of a delay in the action, so we'll hop right back to it. And we're moving on up to set four. A reminder that this week and next week it is all best of seven, so we've still got a little ways to go here, folks.
Yeah. We'll see if we'll get the famous lunch meat. He times in just at the perfect time to
That's
try to get the swords to touch, but
right.
one of my favorite things about playing against Lunch Meat is always watching him try to do
Watching, try and
that.
time it. Okay, here we go. Back to Pod, where Snail in the Coffin has had some success. They've played well so far on this map.
Yeah, and we're getting a really strong open from the Snail in the Coffin team. I mean, we only have Goose up for Soak right now. We have Full Mill up for Snail in the Coffin.
Yeah, I've been impressed. Snail in the Coffin has done exactly what I thought they ought not to do, and that's go full mill, but it has worked out well for them. And just like that, we see Hattrick getting a nice. Oh no, sorry. That was Tree Bones going down. I thought Hattrick had a kill.
Yeah, but Earthbowser Mace taking down Goose after trading, so only one mill up for the Snail in the Coffin team.
Yep, so gold looking like they're in pretty good shape right now. They're gonna get Goose up our right side, it looks like. So they are gonna be going full mill loadout as well.
Yeah, and we're seeing this Speed Sword Goose get up. So Soak is starting to stack those power ups that they're known
Oh,
so well for.
nice
Instant dividends
pinch.
for Goose.
Yep, nice pinch there on the right. Goose gets that kill. So now blue, they're in rough shape. Ooh, Danny wanted the finish. Blue is gonna get a couple mill up as well though, so let's see if they can do something with it, but Danny swoops in,
Yeah,
finishes off, nice kill.
Tree Bones was stuck between the bros there. Couldn't get out between Goose holding one column and Danny holding the other. Great job
Yep.
from Soak.
Okay, so Soak Squad takes the first map of set four, and here we go to BQK. Is this possibly the first one we've seen tonight? I wanna say.
I think so. We were going to see one in the first map lineup, but I believe it was the fifth map, but this is a really strong map for Soak,
Yeah.
so.
Yeah, they like this map. They typically do pretty well here. Gnar likes to get on that snail as he does right there. Once they get in the tunnel, it's pretty dangerous. But Jeff making it interesting,
Yeah.
getting a kill.
Big kill from Jeff there, and Tree Bones is simultaneously able to take down Danny, so they only have Goose up for ledge on this against the Snail in the Coffin team.
Okay, so this is interesting now. We see Tree Bones goes down, but Blue is pushing berries. I like it. I like it a lot. I think that's a really good strat on this map. And they're gonna have half hive here, so that is
Yeah.
gonna force Gold's hand, and they're gonna have to get a ledge up. But Tree Bones is down to last life.
Yeah, and so they do only have four berries left, but this is gonna be really
Yeah.
hard for Tree Bones without any mill.
Yeah, can Tree Bones stay alive long enough to trust his workers to finish it off? Or is that HDD ledge going to be too strong and somebody's going to swoop in and get the kill on Tree Bones?
Yeah, they are able to get up a Hattrick Swayze, so that's going to be a big help for this team. Oh, and Earthbowser with the
Oh.
headbutt gets two berries in.
Yeah, so that's huge right there. All of a sudden,
Oh, and
they just need
Hattrick.
two, and lunch is on last. But that snail
Hattrick.
is moving, and oh, here we go, blue down to one.
Yeah,
Oh, Goose,
great job from Goose there. So he has the
massive
patience just to
kill.
wait for the clear for on Tree Bones.
Wow. Okay, high drama there. Very well played by Goose. Man, lunch was on last. That snail was getting awfully close, and blue just needed one more berry. Great map. Back to split. We've seen these teams have split here on split. They've taken one map apiece. Last time we saw Gold get out to a really commanding early lead with berries. Oh, and here we go. Lunch Meat wins the open with a strong start.
Yeah, and so Gnar already has these berries going in. Great steal there from
Ooh, Earth Bowser.
Hattrick
Nice
Swayze.
kill. On the right, down low, taking down Lunch Meat to even things up. Things are tied on berries just about. Things are tied on queen lives, so we got ourselves a close one.
Yeah, and so Goose is doing a little bit of draining on these top berries for the blue side. I do like that the Soak squad focuses on getting these top berries in because if we saw earlier, it's so much harder to get the top berries in as opposed to the
Yep.
bottom ones later.
Yeah, that ended up being Blue's undoing. They needed tops while Gold needed bottoms, and those bottom ones can just go so much quicker than having to climb yourself all the way up and getting one blue,
Yeah.
one berry at a time up top.
Yeah, and just like that, I mean, these blue warriors are ledging this top hive, but gold has them done on the bottom.
Yep. Goose, once again, finishing things off. And now, all of a sudden, Soak Squad, what was once a very close match, Soak Squad goes up 3-1 on Snail in the Coffin, and move in here to set 5, where they can end this once and for all.
Yeah, so we'll see if this is truly going to put the snail in the coffin for looking for a gold medal for.
That's right. Yeah, this was one of our quickest sets yet. It seemed like gold side was clicking pretty well. Lunch Meat won some opens there, and Tree Bones and Company just not really able to get anything going. Not able to get that momentum.
Lunch at 19-3, Danny at, I think, 15-4. Good strong numbers from these teams. You know it's good when your warrior has similar stats to your queen. You're doing something right.
That's always a good sign. So here we go. It is best of 7, folks. Soak Squad up 3-1. And we're moving to a 5th set. Will it be the last one? That remains to be seen. Winner will move on to the Tier 1 West Finals, while loser will drop down and go into the bronze medal match.
Yeah, so we're starting off on this Nesting Flats Beetlejuice map once again. It's been, I think, both times it went in favor to Soak, but I've seen Tree Bones has some really nice pathing as well, so can't count out the Mill Snail for this Snail in the Coffin team.
Yeah, Blue Side has really threatened with that Snail. They had it really, really close to the finish line there a couple times, but that gold ledge was able to hang tight there, and Soak Squad has played this map really, really well so far.
Yeah, so you can see Gnar is kind of opting to take a little bit of a early snail lead, I think, to probably combat with that trouble they were having pulling it back last time.
But Treebone's off to a quick start, wins the open, and gets the kill on Lunch Meat, as he's done many, many times here tonight.
Yeah, Treebone's looking good. I would love to see this blue team get up. They do get Hattrick up, that's good, but I think 1 mil for them is going to be really difficult. They really need 2 to handle the Soak Warriors right now.
Yep. And just like that, Tree Bones does go down to even things up. That snail is more or less in neutral position. So neither team with a huge advantage, although blue is wiped. So gold side up on the I don't even know who got that kill, but there are 3 warriors there for Soak. All just swarm Tree Bones with nowhere to go.
Ooh, Tree Bones in a really rough
spot. Yeah, he's getting chased all over this map, and Lunch Meat finally takes him down.
There was
nowhere to go.
Yeah, they had Soak had such good positioning. I mean, no matter where they were pushing Tree Bones, they were either cutting him off at those side gates or punishing him, catching him on a ledge like Lunch just did there. Really great stuff from Soak with their coordination.
Yeah, this Soak military feels like they're starting to click. Sets 2 and 3 were a little rough for them, but now it feels like they're firing on all cylinders here, and when they get going, that can be bad news for opposing queens. And there it is.
From Lunch off of the open. Yep. We do have an Earth Bowser Snail moving though, so a little bit of objective for Snail.
Hey, I'd like to see Blue to get more of that, to see if they can get some of that early objective pressure going. Lunch Meat picking up another kill. He's heating up right now. But Gnar has been doing a great job, really, of neutralizing that Snail here these past couple maps and not letting Blue do what they like to do here.
We do have some, as we like to call it, some nice desperation berries going on the snail in the coffin. So they're not going down without a fight.
It's not a bad strategy. I like it. I like it a lot, actually. If you know things aren't falling for you in the military side of things, switch it up. No need to keep slamming your head against the wall. And now they're only 3. Oh, would have been 3 berries. They're 4 berries out. Missed dunk there from Earth Bowser. But berries very much a winnable strat here.
Yeah, and in that time, they were able to rebuild some of their warriors, too. So they do have a mace up in Jeff. I wonder if they'll try to win on berries. Ooh.
Yeah, nice clear by Jeff. So there's no ledge. Lunch Meat's, he's got no choice. He's got all his lives, but Lunch Meat's going to have to get up there. He's hanging down low, but he's got to get up top. Earth Bowser's going to get in. Oh, he misses a throw. Dunk that. Okay, Earth Bowser needs 2 more. Lunch Meat, got to get up there. They need that ledge.
I'm going to be so impressed if they are able to win berries against the Soak team. Jeff
gets the kill. Lunch Meat was messing around with the berry, trying to kick it out of the way. Caught it with his hand in the cookie jar. Jeff got the kill, and Blue just needs 1. These Silk
Yeah,
Warriors are gonna
Jeff
have to
is.
scramble now to get their win condition, and that's killing Dreebones.
Oh, Jeff is looking so good. I say that, I jinx him, of course, but really good stuff there from Jeff with his mace escorting.
Yeah, Lunch quickly going, tagging some gates so that his warriors can get up. But man, it's up to him. He's gonna have to keep an eye up top there and farm these babies. Not let them get up. Oh, here we go. Jeff's got the game-winning berry. Nope, he's cleared out.
Yeah, is Jeff gonna get that last berry? And it's looking like he might make it.
Oh, Lunch! Oh, Lunch gets cleared, and Jeff dunks it in. Oh, the berry win. Wow, check out this play. Very nice kill there. I believe that was Hattrick clearing out Lunch as he had to come under to try and make the play, and Jeff finished it off.
I take it back. They're not desperation berries.
No.
They're success berries. You're right, Obo. Success berries.
Yeah, no, I like that. That hard counter was great. They were getting worked pretty hard in the military game, so while Silk was busy doing that, we saw Earth Bowser in particular just started chucking them in. A phenomenal play. I like it. I like it a lot.
So no ledge up for either of these teams. We do not have that many berries in for Snail in the Coffin 2, and Silk is getting up Goose on Sword right now. Oh, good kill from Lunch right there, coming through the wrap down on top of Tree Bones.
Yep. And we're going to see Gnar. He's going to get up sword and board, so he's going to be going ledge. Goal looking like they're in pretty good shape. We see Danny working the berry game a little bit down low. We're going to have a Goose sword and board up top. I imagine the Gnar sword and board may go down low. Ooh, he gets cleared. He's probably pretty unhappy about that. Okay, so Blue, they've got their bottom berries. They've got Hattrick legend down low. But as we mentioned before, those top berries are so hard to finish off.
Tree Bones just barely got out of there in time. I'm not sure somebody stunned him out of the way, but I thought he was gonna die in that top hive. But so done with their top berries.
Yep, done with top. Gnar is gonna be running berries here on out the rest of the way, as the Silk brothers both have their swords up. Gnar gonna get one in there. And here we go. Here comes the berry flood.
Lunch.
And yep, this'll do it. Lunch was trying to get
Lunch,
one
let's
in.
Go.
Gnar
Lunch
looking
get
for
that
a berry.
Berry in.
Gnar can't find the berry though, okay. And Tree Bones gets a kill. All right, this is not over yet. Gnar's got to find himself a berry and get this last dunk. Blue still needs four up top, though.
Earth Bowser! What a play. I thought that Gnar had that in for sure.
I thought Hattrick was going to run some berries. He's got the gun, though, instead. Yeah, he opted for the gun. Interesting. So perhaps Blue not thinking that they're going to win on berries. Perhaps they're trying to just get kills on Lunch and Ledge here.
Yeah.
But Goose also with the pew pew.
Got that kill. Oh, is he looking for the?
Oh, Danny finishes it off. He looks to get that last berry when possible, and he succeeds there.
I was too busy watching to see if Goose was going to get our first Moonraker in an IGL match. If he was gonna seal the glory from our beloved Retro.
Yeah, he went for it. But here we go, Tally Fields. This is a map that Silk has looked really strong in, and a win here will move them on and advance to the finals.
Yeah, I will say I think that Tally is probably Lunch Meat's best map. He's so good at holding these wraps and locking out people from getting into gates.
Okay, so we do see HDD is up, of course. We see them running that split strat that they like to do with Gnar pulling Snail a little bit, Goose running berries. So Gold looking pretty strong, but Blue is not far behind.
Yeah, so we do have one mil up for each team.
There we
Big
go.
Kill from Tree
There's
Bones
Tree Bones.
Tree Bones doing three phones things.
Okay, we got the double ledge. Ooh, nice kill. The HDD does go down to Jeff's mace. And Blue all of a sudden looking pretty strong in the military game, moving that Snail a little bit.
Yeah, you know Hattrick has the Wallen ball. He's not going down. As soon as I say it, he goes down.
Ooh,
big kill from Gnar.
Yeah,
wrap on Tree Bones.
Gnar, very, very nice. While Goose continues to make berries from long distance, looking for a berry though. He's at about half hive here, but Blue does keep moving that Snail.
They are going to be able to get a Hattrick, so that's going to
help
a little bit.
Gnar was making some nice tosses. Earth Bowser with a nice drone interception, though, and goes and dunks that in his own hive. Tree Bones here, though, on last life.
On tournament life.
Yep.
Tournament life against
the soak on Tally. That's a little bit scary.
Yep.
I like what Hattrick's doing, though. He's looking to protect Tree Bones a little bit, keep him away from Lunch and those mates.
Okay, so Gnar doing a good job riding that snail back. Ooh, Lunch on last life. Gold now just needs 3 berries. Blue at half hive, but they are riding that snail back pretty hard. This could be a very viable win condition for them. If they can continue to move that snail, it's going to force Lunch Meat's hand, and he is on last life. Gold, however, just needs one more berry. Ooh, tries the toss. Double ledge up, though. It's going to be hard to get it.
Yeah, great escorting there from Danny, but the soak team is white.
Oh, here we go. Watch out. Lots of berries on Gold's side. Danny and Goose both want the throw. There are some berries on Blue's hive as well, so I'd be a little worried here. Goose is real slippery. Oh,
tree bones.
Getting the kill.
On tournament life, getting that kill.
Forcing a game five. Wow. Okay, that is the first time that Soak goes down on Tally here tonight. And game five, back to Pod, a map that I think Snail in the Coffin has looked pretty strong at so far here tonight.
Wow. Our second game five of the series so far. Really great stuff from both of these teams. Such exciting games. But Lunch Meat with the absolutely dominating open.
Yeah, Lunch Meat looking strong right now. Just 2 kills away from advancing his team to the finals. Both teams here, I think they're just going full mill. We're not going to be seeing any berry tossing. We haven't seen any snail riding. Here we go, looking like a liar.
Stuff there from Jeff on Leftgate. Love to see it.
HDD is up on speed. Blue just going a full vanilla. Oh, but Earth Bowser not needing any power ups, getting a kill.
Yeah, looking really good. But this Danny on speed is going to be problematic for Soak.
Yeah, they got Gnar up on speed as well. They got Goose Vanilla, so they got full mill going here. This is what they like. This is where they're most comfortable. Blue, though, they're going to have a pretty good military game here as well. Oh, but Lunch Meat making them pay, clearing them out. And Tree Bones once again on his match life.
Yeah, this is looking really scary for Tree
Bones. Oh,
right,
the
now.
Clash.
Oh, Tree Bones. You're absolutely wild.
so dangerous. Yeah, he is. He wants. Oh, Goose gets the tournament. Finals advancing kill here. Very well played. Goose has been coming up clutch all match long and gets the final kill of the night.
Yeah, great stuff there from Soak closing it out, going to their second finals in a row onto this West Tier 1 circuit. So great stuff there. Big kills across the board, but I think this mill from the Soak team was just a little bit too much for Snail in the Coffin to handle, but they definitely held their own. I was very impressed with their play.
Absolutely. Now, if you're Snail in the Coffin, I mean, again, very, very few teams this season, just them and Golf Bites, have even been able to take a set off Soak. And they forced Soak to a couple game fives. And, you know, they made it this far into the semifinals. They've had themselves a phenomenal run. Their season is not yet over. They are going to be playing next week. So they've still got a chance at that bronze medal. So real hats off to Snail in the Coffin. Very well played.
You love to see all of these guys taking a page out of the good old Tear Bears book and shuffling it up, doing a little shuffle hell after the game.
Doing a little shuffle after the game just for kicks. But man, that was a fun one.
Yeah, that was really, really good stuff there. I just can't say how proud I am of the Snail in the Coffin team from going from last season where they didn't win a single set against any of their teams to almost to going to 2 game fives against Soak, and now they're in contention for this bronze medal.
Yeah, absolutely. That was a lot of fun. So as we mentioned, they're going to play next week in the bronze medal match. They will be playing the loser of your team, Terror Bears, versus Dave's Killer Queen, and Soak advancing to the finals to take on the winner of tomorrow night's matchup. So as we previewed before the start of the match, there still are a couple other games left this weekend. So go ahead, do check out Bee's Almanac. As she throws up in chat there, a reminder, less than 24 hours left to get your surveys done. Those are very important to let the community, let the IGL seating community know your thoughts. And, you know, there's a possibility next season will be a double elimination tournament. So go ahead and get that in.
Yeah. Love to see that double elimination tournament. Definitely would give some of these teams a little bit more of a chance to rise through the loser's bracket. So
yeah,
I personally am a big fan of it. I think it's going to be really great, but excited to hear what everybody else says.
Yeah, absolutely. Fun stuff all the way around. Man, Elise, glad to have you in studio for casting this fun one. Any final words before we get on out of here?
Yeah, I'm actually going to steal a page out of Retro's book. You know, Retro loves all the puns, but he had a really important one in all serious earlier. Escargot to the polls, so just going to end on
there
that.
There we go. Awesome. Well, hey, Elise, thanks so much for coming by. We'll be sure to do it again sometime. So special thanks to her, guys. You can catch her streams right here on Twitch. Her handle is EGFree. Thanks as well to both teams for putting on a hell of a matchup. Especially the team captains, HDD and Treebones, for helping me coordinate all of this, letting me stream. Also, big thanks as always to my producer, Mr. Meeseeks, all that he does behind the action. And of course, you, the audience, including everyone who followed along, subscribed, and donated. Thank you so very much. This has been The Big Show, and I'm Big Chungus, reminding you to get involved, win your clashes, and as always, have fun. Be sure to tune in next time for continued coverage of the 2020 Summer Circuit Playoffs. Until then, happy gaming, everyone, and good night.